Would high-dose thiamin cause imbalances with other B vitamins?
Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind, or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first, and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode.
All right, Heather Chandler says, could high-dose thiamin deplete other B vitamins or compete with them for absorption? If they do compete, would taking the high-dose Bs at a different meal from the others mitigate the problem? I don't think thiamin transport is going to compete with other B vitamins. And so I don't think taking them at a different meal from the others is going to do anything about that. However, I do think it's possible that any one B vitamin might drive the other B vitamins into certain pathways, and that might cause imbalances in the pathways. And that is, the evidence for that is largely limited to the fact that I have seen a couple old studies that megadosed one B vitamin and saw blood levels drop of the others. But given that thiamin is, given that its reaction pathways largely line up with most of the other B vitamins, it's not clear that that's actually a concern. But I do think that it makes, you know, if you're megadosing one B vitamin, you want to at least make sure that you're not deficient in any of the others. So shoot for the higher end of the range of plausible dietary requirements with the others if you are megadosing one for a specific reason, and don't megadose any of them unless you do have a specific reason. But there are the main B vitamins that are going to compete for absorption are biotin, B5, and lipoic acid, which is not a B vitamin, do share a transporter. But I don't think thiamin is an issue with that. All right, thank you, Heather, for your question.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ Master Pass, where I hold monthly private Zoom Q&As for my members. The Master Pass also serves as a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. If you'd like to participate in these Q&As, you can join the Master Pass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for 10% lifetime discount. I am currently working full-time on finishing my first book, Vitamins and Minerals 101, How to Get the Nutrients You Need on Any Diet. I will let you know when I have a release date. In the meantime, you can pre-order the book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. Testing Nutritional Status, the Ultimate Cheat Sheet, has been newly released as version 1.3. This is my comprehensive system for managing nutritional status with lab tests, dietary analysis, and comprehensive intake of your signs and symptoms. The new version has a comprehensive guide to interpreting the Genova methylation panel. You can pick up your copy at chrismasterjohnphd.com/cheat sheet. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. Please consider supporting my work at no extra cost to you by visiting my support page and making a purchase with one of my affiliate links. Some of my most popular affiliates are also listed in the description of this video with links that will give me credit for your purchase. I will try to respond to comments when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.